So I guess I'll first start off by saying that this video is going to be for people that know how to do some type of color correction or color grading, as we're not really going to be focusing on how to use the nodes and the color tools. What we're going to be focusing on here is once we make those corrections, how we can actually save them to use them further down in the timeline, as well as in other projects, and potentially even give those corrections to other people so that they would be able to do that. Kind of like a LUT, I guess you could say. So in this shot here that I'm working with, here is how it first was out of camera. And then I added in a color correction to get rid of that ugly light source that was in the room. So let's go over to the color page, and I want to show you how you can copy over a corrections or a set of corrections that we already have. So here on the color page, we can see we have a couple of nodes here, and we can see right around here, it's showing that there is a correction on here, but there isn't one over here. Let's click on the second shot. And now let's copy this grade over here. Now, the easiest way to do this is just to hit your middle mouse button when you're hovering over another shot, and it'll automatically copy those over. So that's an easy way of doing it. The other way that we could go about doing this is if we want to save, let's say, a look, or we want to save almost like a LUT and be able to reference back to that at a later point in time in a couple of different ways, actually. So the first way is going to be very similar to how we had all of the nodes. And then I want to show you one in the viewer that we can actually use if we want a color match or skin tone match or something of that nature. So all we would have to do is let's go back to the shot that is at a point in which we want to save the information. We're just going to right click in here and go grab still. You don't really see anything here, but if we go up into our gallery, we'll see that we have that shot up here now. So let's go over to our other shot here. Now, if we were to, let's say we just wanted to change the way in which this shot was, but we wanted the skin tones to be the same. One thing that we could do is we could come over to this shot here, right click and go play still. Now we have the ability to move this around, and we can see the difference in skin tone there. So we would be able to work with that, and we could slide this around to get an idea of what our shot looks like. There's a bunch of options up here to work with still images like that. But okay, so now we have it over here, but there are actually are a couple other options that we can do with this. We can actually just middle mouse button, and it'll do the same thing that we were doing here, but they're all up here. So you could have multiple different looks. Let's say we grab this look, and let's make a crazy look, and then we come back over to here, and we could simply go like this and get an idea of what those looks look like. Sometimes while we're working, we have really complicated node structures, and we might want to go in and just pull a couple of those nodes. Well, we could do that by just going into any one that we want. We right click and we go display node graph. It pops up this little window, and we can see all of the different nodes that are here. And if we want to grab a node, so let's say we grab this node, we can just grab it and add it onto our project. Obviously, you would probably want to put labels, and those labels will copy over into here. If you've never used labels, you just right click and then you go into node label, and then we'd be able to type in something here. And then if we were to grab another still and then display that, we would then see that information written there. You typically want to write nodes once you get some complicated node structures. But so that's how we would do that. Now, if we were to go into another project, I have another project here, and we were to look in here, let's add some media in here because I got two more shots from the same location. And as you can see over here, we don't have any of those stills to work with. So let's go back over into our first project, and I want to show you how you can actually copy them over. So clicking up here, we can see that we have stills and power grade. The difference between these two is stills is just going to be just for that particular project. You can go through any of your different timelines, but it's just going to be in that one project, where power grades are going to be shared across your whole project library. So if we go into here, and let's do the same exact thing that we previously had. Let's just remove that one, and then we go grab still. And now it's in here. Let's go over back to that other project that we were working with, and we'll come into here, and we can see that we now have one in here. So we could just simply middle mouse button and it'll add that on just like that. So now we automatically copied those over. Now remember, this is the whole grade. You could just pull out particular nodes if there's something about those nodes that you like. You don't have to pull the whole thing. that is a way in which that we would be able to copy over all of our stuff. Now, if you were watching, you've seen that I had some extra stuff in here. And this is actually a PowerGrid library that I have on my website that you can download, but they're pretty much just like LUTs. Instead of having LUTs, which are just going to be predefined number conversions, going from this color number to that color number, this is actually all of the correctors, but it does the same exact thing, and we can do more than that. So let's go back to how we had this initially. Let's say that this was our correction, right? So our color correction. This isn't our color grade, this is just our color correction to get back to more of a neutral, or maybe what it actually looked like on set while we were filming. But we want to go in and let's say we want to add in something here. We could go into any of these. Hovering over allows you to see them, but let's go in and display node graph, and we can see the nodes that are here. I can just simply click on this, drag it over, and now I have all of the nodes from that color grade. Kind of like a LUT, but we have the ability to go into here and see all of the different controls which changed how this looks. So we could go into each one of these, and let's say we wanted to not have this so teal, and maybe we want it to be purple. I can flip this over and have it purple if I want to, right? But I'm still having the rest of the corrections. Now, yes, you could do that with a LUT. You could apply your LUT and then go in and say, okay, the blues, I want to switch it. But here's where it gets a little more complicated and it would be significantly more difficult to do. We can see that we have this drop high saturation node. If I click in here and I go over to where the saturation is, we can see that we're grabbing the higher saturation areas and pulling it down a little bit and increasing saturation in other areas. This would be very difficult to reverse in a LUT compared to if we're working with power grades. We can easily come in here, either turn the node off or modify it to fit our liking. So let's go back over to this particular node that we were working with, and or actually this one, we can come back over to the other power grade and we can just add that in there, come over here and we can hit middle mouse button, and now we have that over here. And that's pretty intense purple in the back there. Let's go in and maybe adjust that a little bit. But we have the ability to do this, no problems, right? We can adjust it as much as we want. And if we didn't want it, we could just remove it. Super, super simple. This is a very dark shot. Now I'm looking at it. And so that's how we would save a color grade. Now, yes, you could have a LUT, but it's not going to have the same information that a power grade would have. You know, if we take a look at this node 3, we have a resolve effect on there. That's not something you can put it in a LUT. And, you know, that might be critical for the look in which that particular scene was using, and having the ability to have it in a power grade would really open up the ability or open up the opportunities for you to recreate that same look in a completely different project. So hopefully you guys found this entertaining. Hopefully you guys learned something. If you want to know more about DaVinci Resolve, I have a whole website with a ton of different courses going over every aspect of DaVinci Resolve. I also have a bunch of free titles on there if you're interested in those. And if you want some pre-made assets, I have those, like titles, transitions, you know, all of those sort of things on there. So take a look. And with that being said, my name's JR. Thanks so much for watching. Till the next one. Peace.